Rainwater cannot penetrate urban landscapes and infiltrate into the ground, causing trillions of gallons of fresh water to flow out of our cities and into our watersheds. This water could be used to replenish our water table. Our freshwater needs are high. Water to drink, to bathe, to clean our clothes, to keep our lawns green, and to irrigate our crops. But wouldn't it be great if we could keep stormwater runoff from entering our watershed altogether and allow it to infiltrate back into the ground and replenish our decreasing water table? This can be done, but we may need to remove a building or two and plan for additional space in new construction projects. Stormwater can be redirected into infiltration rain gardens. When properly designed, stormwater can filter through the soil, purify, and return to the water table. Rain gardens can be on an individual level to trap runoff from your home, and they don't have to be very big. Infiltration rain gardens are being designed into new residential developments. Commercial developers create rain gardens large enough to capture all of the rain from the buildings and parking lots. After a heavy rain, these rain gardens are doing their job. Public roadway projects can incorporate rain gardens in ditches and clover leaves. Every rain garden needs to be sized according to the soil's ability to infiltrate water. And all soils are different. There are literally hundreds of different soil types possible, and each will infiltrate at different rates. The slower the infiltration rate, the larger the rain garden needs to be. Hydraulic conductivity of soil, KSAT, is the infiltration measurement and is called out as centimeters per second or inches per hour. This value is used to calculate the size and design of an infiltration rain garden. In the past, the only way to measure this was using the manual double ring test. This method produces an accurate calculation for only that specific spot. After a day of recording data on a clipboard, one must then perform the KSAT math calculation, which can take several hours and has the potential for introducing simple human errors. The MPD infiltrometer replaces the double ring test and is an automated instrument that anyone can operate, and each test only takes 30 to 45 minutes to perform. A graduated cylinder is tapped into the ground and filled with 3 liters of water. The test begins and all data is automatically recorded, removing human error. 3 tests may be performed simultaneously and data is transferred wirelessly and recorded on a tablet. The MPD infiltrometer can perform dozens of tests scattered across a site in the same time it takes to perform 1 double ring test. All of the MPD test results can then be averaged to get the best representation of the overall site. When all tests are complete, the user may then immediately download an infiltration site report, which includes the site name and date, a weighted sum mean value for the entire site, a table with individual test results, a satellite photo of the site with GPS pins showing the location of each test. Subsequent pages show the raw data for each test. Once a rain garden has been created, it needs to be maintained. They need to be inspected twice a year and remove any sediment buildup and test infiltration to ensure it is still working properly. Upstream Technologies is committed to the design and distribution of products that return our watershed environments to a natural state.